Welcome back to Cradle. We've arrived at the amusement park where we apparently have to play a very strange virtual reality minigame to gain access to the breathing module, so that Ida can actually breathe and not feel like she's dying all the time. So, let's get to it. There's a long list of instructions here. Don't fall into the water, points, gain 30 blue cubes. I'm just gonna wing it. Alright, it said throw cubes into, like, the stream going upwards. Like, throw blue cubes into that. This place is very pretty. These blocks are so shiny. Okay, so I can subtract blocks. I mean, am I on a time limit here? It doesn't seem like it. And I believe it said to create platforms, put blue blocks on white blocks? Like this? Yes, okay. Okay, so I guess you multiply your blue blocks by putting them on white blocks? Oh, you don't look good. Get away from me. Just subtracted a bunch of things. Oh no! Come back here! Uh-oh. Oh, I think touching the water, which is what I'm in right now, reduces your score. Thankfully my score is zero, so I guess it doesn't really matter. This is, odd. This is very, very odd. So that should give me 1 point, right? Yeah, there we go. Huh. Oh god. Okay, well I guess I'll just keep getting rid of these and... this is kind of like Minecraft, slightly? Like, I'm digging for blocks? And then I guess I'll just attach any blue block I find to... don't fall. To a white block. And multiply them. What is the blue thing doing? What? The stream disappeared for a second. It rejected my blue block. Come back here. Oh god. Oh god. This is very, very strange. Oh god. And by strange, I mean this feels completely pointless and just bizarre. I should probably make, like, stairs to the upper level. It really is like I'm playing Minecraft right now. Nah, screw it. Oh. Oh, is that where it sucks all loose blocks in? I think it is. Oh god! My score! Oh! Yeah, I think when it sucks everything in, that, cleans up all the loose blocks. I need blue, need blue, need blue. I've got a bunch of platforms. Ugh. 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 Alright, whatever. I totally hit you. And I don't know what's up with these red blocks. I'd like to reread the rules, but I don't know how to do that. Oh, looks like it's sucking all the cubes in. Yeah, is there any way to reread the rules? No? Maybe if I go back to the top. Actually, can I even go back to the top? And what if I put a red one? Oh. Yeah, what does a red one do? Nothing, apparently. Oh no! I don't get it. I mean, I know I'm completing it, I get this game, but I mean, I don't get why this exists in this game. This feels so utterly pointless. What even is this? Oh, that's what it does if you touch it to the red one. It explodes. Oh god. My score! Oh, come on. Fine, I'll Minecraft my way up. This game is not a good platformer, but I'm having to do a lot of platforming. Alright, we're almost there. Thanks. Okay, this actually should be the last one right here. I think. Unless, oh, no, it just sprayed them all to the bottom. Alright, two more. Come on, last one, and... Alright, that should be it. Please tell me that's the end of this. Please tell me there's no more mini-games. I really don't get the point of that. I don't get it at all. Why did that even exist? Okay, got it. Oh, do I get to go down the chute? Please tell me I get to go down the chute. I'm going down the chute. That's all I came here for, right? Find a way to exit the territory of the complex. Oh yeah, that's right.
I don't know whether this would be useful, but there were people that were dubbed outsiders. For whatever reason, they sought to spread the sterility virus. They were the reason the virus became a global scourge. But how they did it, or why, that I do not remember.
Yeah, I just remembered that I never was able to find a way to actually get back over the fence. After I jumped. I remember I looked from side to side and there was apparently no way back. So that might be difficult. But I just realized, before I do anything else, I actually want to see, like, these other things, can I actually get sucked into these tubes too? Oh my god, I can. Can I play these, too, if I wanted to? Oh, right, I would need her to open the door. I wonder if there's secrets hidden up here, though. You know, notes or something? Well, I don't really feel like painstakingly checking every single one. Character hesitated there for some reason. It's like some sort of safety slide. It seems to slow you down when you get to the bottom. Alright, so none of these doors are going to open, obviously. But. What about this place? This place where I thought there was something to do. Because all the lights come on when you step inside here. Is there really nothing to do here? I guess not. I'm not seeing anything popping up. Just these report cards to look at and that's it? Because it looks like this thing, like, transports you up in this tube, maybe, up to that building or something. And I'd like to go into those buildings. Hazardous waste containers? Hey, what's this? Herbert Martinez, 5 years, HQ 74. This was printed like 15 years ago or so. Okay, wait a minute. So the thing I read, the report that I read on that machine, the consciousness transfer machine, back at the yurt, when it was describing the whole procedure and how it went down, you know, everything working, and then eventually an error and manual override and all that stuff. And at the end it said, whoa. No, it didn't say whoa. It said liquidated, right? The person got liquidated. Is that what these containers are? They have people's names on them, identifying numbers, HQ level, and they appear to be hazmat containers. And I don't know about you, but I think if you were to liquidate a person, you could probably fit them inside of these containers. Oh god, run. Alright, I'm getting out of here, but yeah, I think those might be, containers that contain the liquidated bodies of people. That might be it. That really might be it. Alright, let's look for a way out. You know what would be a really cool way to get out of here? Snip this balloon and just ride it up into the wind. Of course, getting down might be a bit of an issue. Alright, so I'm looking for a break in the fence, or a tree or a board or something that goes over. I don't think I'm supposed to go up here. Does this game have fall damage? Nope. Okay, anyway, what was I doing? Right, breaking the fence. Or a tree leaning on it. Okay, so that's a thing. Looks like you can throw sticks at the black toxin monsters and they explode. Let's do it again. Yeah, that'll teach him a lesson. Well, I have no idea if this is actually going to accomplish anything, but I feel like doing some hardcore parkour. Let me see if I can get a little bit of a safety net. Nope. Don't suppose there's another panel around here. A loose one? Nope. Okay. Hardcore parkour! Oh god. Please get back on the railing. Or don't. Ow. So yeah, there actually is fall damage. Although, you just wake up where you landed. Why are there feathers on the ground? Did those just happen to be here, or did those feathers come off of me? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. There's no way those feathers were just there. Hold on, I'm gonna fall again. If feathers appear on the ground wherever I fall, then something is very, very strange. Okay. There's nothing. Were there really just feathers right where I fell? Let me try that one more time. This time I'm going to land on the ground itself. Because that time I landed on some concrete or something. There's a feather! That was not there before, was it? Am I going insane? Let's just look around this thing. Are there any feathers already on the ground, other than the one that seems to have just appeared? No. Okay. One more time. There's a feather! Why is there a feather on the ground where I die? What does it mean? What does it mean? I need to know. I'm suddenly acutely aware of the fact that I can't see my own body and I've never seen my reflection, and the only person I've actually talked to, Ida, also can't see. Which makes me think, based on the fact that when I fall there's a feather on the ground, that perhaps I'm some sort of Birdman or something. Am I Birdman? Which, by the way, that's a really good movie. If you haven't seen Birdman, you should really watch it. It's really good, seriously. I was really surprised just how good it was. But yeah, seriously, am I a Birdman? Or is that just some reference to, like, Ongots or something? I don't know. I don't get it. Or does my clothes just have a lot of feathers on it, and so I leave a feather wherever I fall? That is so strange. That is so, so strange. Has anyone else noticed that? Like, I wonder. That's a small detail, and I'm guessing almost nobody would have found it. Has anybody else ever found that? Could I be the first one to discover the strange feather? The feather effect? Anyway, I think I was trying to parkour, right? Oh, there we go. Oh god. Well, here's another feather. There's three feathers.
What does it mean?
Anyway, I'm gonna keep looking around for the way out. Okay, this might be it. So I've just been going up to each one of these towers looking for something that might be able to help me. And I noticed that the railing's knocked out here, and this looks like you're really meant to walk on it. Yeah. Yeah. I think this is where I'm supposed to go. Oh god. That doesn't sound good. Please don't fall. Oh. Okay. Wait a minute. I just found something. This little, like, broken part of a ride here. It's hard to tell from, like, almost every angle, but there's actually a control panel here. Oh, and I can even sit in the seat. Okay. What? What the fuck is this thing gonna do? How is this supposed to get me out? What? Okay, this is kinda awesome, but like, how am I supposed to know that this, like, ancient piece of dead machinery embedded in the ground just needed me to press one button and it would suddenly become a hover cart on a control panel that's almost impossible to see from almost every angle that you come at this thing from? What? That was unnecessarily hidden. Take me all the way home. Keep going. Connect the breathing module to Ida. Oh, this is some sort of a ferry transport system back and forth? That's very cool. How was I supposed to know that this thing worked? This thing, how was I supposed to? It didn't even look like it belonged there. It looked like it had, like, fallen off from inside and somehow become embedded outside. Like, what? It's so hard to see the control panel. I mean, you come onto this thing from, like, this direction. You can't see the control panel. Come on from the other direction. You can't see the control panel. Gotta see it from this side to even see any buttons. Jesus. I'm really annoyed. I wasted a lot of time. Where's my yurt? Ida, you better appreciate this. Because you don't want to know how many times I hardcore parkoured my way to death. Don't worry, it's still fine. It's only got a little bit of sand in it. Where does it go?
Did you bring the module?
Yes. How do I install it?
There should be a pipe inside the chest. A trachea. The air passes through it, so you need to connect the module to it somehow.
All right.
Thank you. There we go. Would you like your chest back? No? Speak with Ida. Why can't I put her chest back on? Okay.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Don't mention it.
Finally, I'm breathing.
How goes your search? Did you find the password?
Not yet. But I did remember a bit about myself. I used to work here at the Gerbera Garden as a teacher, I think. I remember kids being brought here to watch a show. They would then play in the pavilions, carry body parts from there, and pile them up by the stage for some reason. What an odd amusement park to build.
Strange indeed that it was built here.
There's something I don't understand. You said it was abandoned, but it's still operating. It's got power. Why wasn't it taken down?
There was an explosion. It's full of some poison. Do you remember anything about that?
I think I know what it was that exploded there. Disparatoxin.
What's that?
That's the substance from which the virus came into being. The epidemic began after one such explosion.
One? You mean there were other explosions?
Several hundred, all across the globe.
Who carried out the explosions?
Remember I was telling you about the outsiders? The explosions were their handiwork.
Were they terrorists? What was their goal?
No goal to speak of. They weren't even doing it on purpose, really. Simply, sometimes their passium capsules would explode in their chests, spontaneously. The emotions-generated substance was the cause.
What was wrong with it?
It had a dangerous component, bitter passium. It's a kind of dark liquid which may suddenly turn poisonous and explode. Those people were carrying a bomb in their chests. It wasn't their intention to massacre thousands of people and strip the entire race of the ability to procreate, but that's what happened.
But how are they different from the others?
Genetic defects. The more defects in the DNA, the more bitter the passium becomes. Outsiders were at once pitied and feared. Nobody wanted to live next to a time bomb. Many outsiders left their hometowns. They didn't want to cause anyone trouble.
So that's why they were called outsiders.
They were called all sorts of things, including lower class and ugly people. I still remember the slogan. Protect society from the emotions of ugly people.
What an unexpected problem for society.
But not the only problem. Living in an M-body requires fuel, and fuel can only be obtained in exchange for sweet passium. Provided you have it, which the outsiders did not. They were unwitting spongers.
Spongers?
They were issued poor heredity assistance from the Public Rescue Fund. The fund was founded and sustained by a special tax that was levied on all the citizens. First and foremost, on the beautiful elite. A lion's share of the reserves went towards supporting ugly people. Thus, they became a constant headache, not only spreading the virus, but also draining the rescue fund.
Those ugly, poisonous spongers.
It was their emotions that were poisonous. Uglies are dangerous merely by living and feeling, in that they deprive the rest of any hope of returning to the way things were. I remember all the heated debates, the frantic search for a solution.
Oh my god. Uglies are dangerous merely by living and feeling. This is seriously messed up. This is like elitism and upper class taken to an extreme. Elitism in, I guess, just in your body, more than anything. Not an elitism from having, like, lots of money or something like that, but an elitism from just having a good body. I mean, you know, people with bad bodies, people that aren't generally considered attractive, and things like that, are already, you know, looked down upon by a lot of people. So, ugly people, so-called ugly people, or people with genetically defective DNA, as well, are already looked down upon by a lot of society, but this is like taking that, you know, that the terrible thing that already exists of looking down upon people for something that wasn't their choice at all. You know, the DNA that you're born with is not your choice. You're just stuck with it. It's like, it's taking something that already exists and already is really bad. And, you know, really horrible for a lot of people that don't have good bodies and don't have good genes and, you know, society shits on them. It's taking something like that and turn it into something that's, like, it's turned it up to 11. Now not only are, you know, they looked down upon because they're not attractive and things like that, but they're also looked down upon because they're literally explosive and may kill people. They're literally dangerous. Just by living and existing. That's so fucking sick.
And did they find it?
Yes, I think so. The committee proposed a hibernation program, putting the uglies to sleep.
Putting the uglies to sleep? Oh my god.
Come again? What kind of sleep?
Deactivation. A voluntary shutdown. A temporary one until the virus is destroyed. And many of them agreed, realizing it was the best option they had. I don't know whether it helped or... Hold on.
So all ugly people had to hibernate.
What?
The password. I think I got the right one. Yes, I'm in. I see the files. Trying to find info on the employees. It should have my data as well.
You've got strange eyesight.
Why's that?
You see virtual files.
I wouldn't refuse regular eyesight either. It's all dark, but I can't figure out what's broken.
The screen on your face. It's broken.
It's called a look screen, and yes, it's damaged.
Might there be a working one at the Gabera Garden?
There probably is, but it won't recover my sight. Something is up with my lens, and the garden wouldn't have those. Nor do I know where to find them.
I suppose I'll look for a lens then.
Where? In the field? There's nobody around. What was that?
Don't know. I'll go check it out.
I think somebody's just arrived. Okay, can I put your chest on now, please? Okay, good. Why didn't she want me to put her chest on for the conversation? Weird. But yeah, I do believe somebody has arrived outside. I'm sorry to be such a tease, but I think I'll end on that cliffhanger. And also the game just saved, so it makes a very good place to end the episode. So yeah, this was kind of frustrating. Playing that, like, wasting 10 minutes of my life on that weird and completely pointless seeming minigame, and then wasting, like, 40 minutes of my life trying to find a way to escape, only to find that a barely visible control panel and a piece of machinery in the front of the amusement park that looked broken and embedded in the ground, turns out that's what you're supposed to press. That was very, very annoying. Very frustrating, but hopefully that's the end of those frustrations. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'll go find out what that noise was.